Well, hello everybody. Welcome back to Euro Truck. And I have a new truck. It's the Volvo Globetrotter. Treat yourself to the more comfortable truck. Why not? So we're in the Netherlands. We're about to go and pick up our trailer, which is Honey, and it's going to Italy. I can't remember the name of the place, but some daylight's on here. Okay. So let's go and get the trailer first. Now it said there'd been some new updates and I don't think the steering was quite right then. It's reset now. Put me here in the Netherlands in one of my garages. So I don't know what the updates are. I haven't read anything about them. It's a lot more comfortable, this truck. I'm glad I bought it. Cost quite a bit of money, but who cares when you've got millions. This is one of them giveaway junctions. Traffic control, so okay. They're letting me go. I do hate them junctions with no control. The AI, you just gotta bully your way sometimes through. Quite a spacious truck, this. A lot of room in it. I think I've switched the fatigue off. I should have checked actually before I started the game, I'm not too sure. Which means we wouldn't have to sleep. Just do a straight drive there. I wouldn't imagine this attackers for our trailer. Thank you. it? Honey. 20 tons of honey. And we're going to Pescara, is that Italy? This is where we're going. So it's, yeah, northern Italy, isn't it? And the land's round here, and it's near, there's my land here. It's just south of Milan. Paying quite well for it. 73,384 euros, so let's take that job. There's our trailer, you can see it. That's some horses here, nice. I've put the expert attaching for the trailers, so you've got to be bang on with it. Extra challenge really, otherwise it won't let you hook the trailer up. There you go, it's accepted it. Should be good enough. Special stand-up trailer. There are hooks up. I must key a button for, just go straight back in. Always everybody, hope you're all in good health. Been watching the World Cup, enjoying it, and some quite dramatic matches, last minute goals. Just going into the knockout stages now, the groups are finished, so that's where the fun really starts. With the penalty shootouts and all that. So nippy this, I'm about to get some speeding tickets on this. Powerful engine in it. Some roadworks here. So I wonder what the updates are. Must be something considerable, because when they move you from your last, where you left off on your last job, and they just shove you into one of your garages somewhere else. It's usually a major update. Just don't have to rest, so we'll just drive straight to Italy. Tech it would be going through France. Like I say, we're in the Netherlands at the moment, so it's just straight south through France. Switzerland and then into northern Italy, I would think. I've had this Euro truck now for a few years, about 2.5 years I think, and still enjoy it. Still a great simulator. Scenery is fantastic, really. Excellently done. We'll have to stop for fuel at one point. At the moment we're just under a full tank here, but I don't think that'll be enough to see the job out, so we'll there's one stop we'll have to make. I used to have the fatigue on all the time, where you got to drive for so long that you have to sleep. But I find it better actually with it off, and just do a straight drive then. I would think we're going to France now. From the Netherlands to France would make the most sensible option. out. Let's see how it's routed, does it? Where's it taking us? No, it's taking us through Germany, isn't it? Yeah, I'd rather have come. Yeah, I suppose that would have been the longer way, wouldn't it? Yeah, so we're coming into Germany, straight through Germany into Switzerland, and then Northern Italy. Okay, fair enough. I could change that, obviously you can. That just gives you the quickest route, you can then reroute it if you want, but we'll go along with that. Tell you what, this weather's, I mean, I know it's midsummer and they call it Flaming June, but wow, is it hot. I don't know what the temperature is in here, but I'm sweating here. Been all day. Looked at the satellite images and it looks as if it's here for quite a while, this weather, so I suppose we're going to have to get used to it. Not too far from where I live, there's been some fires broke out on the moors. They've been burning now for a few days. They're out of control. It's not something we're used to and struggling to control it. It's just spreading. It's so dry. Everything's bone dry and difficult to get up onto them moors as well. It's okay. Difficult to get vehicles up there. Yeah, it's just going to burn out, I think. It's going to take quite a while for it to just burn itself out. There's a lot of farmland and they've had to rescue the sheep and thankfully they're okay. Sheep were rescued, all the wildlife. I know other countries have, it's quite common to get fires, and this is one of them drop off lanes. It's one of the reasons I hate Germany. They should have slowed down then. We're not used to it in Britain, UK. I think the last time it rained was the beginning of June. We're now coming into July. So everything's bone dry. Yeah, they're very dangerous, them drop-off lanes. Crazy. I mean, I'm sure I used to live in Germany, that they don't exist. It's just been done for the game now. I'm convinced about that. That would be speed camera, that would be very dangerous. So the obvious easy way to do it is to stay in the left lane, the fast lane. Obviously you'd be holding up traffic. Strange as well, because going to Italy, once we get to Italy, you'll see that they don't have those. See where that lane just drops off like that. The turn-offs are separate lanes, which you would indicate, if you was going to turn off, you would indicate into, and then you're in that lane for turning off, and it doesn't just suddenly, you know, you're driving along and then suddenly, got to get out of this lane because it's dropping off. You know, there's the speed. I thought I'd get some of them. I'm not bothered about that. As long as I don't have any accidents. Be that copper there, I think, that got me. Possibly. Unless it was a camera. So when they've coded the Italian section, it's like the UK where you have a lane that you have to signal into to turn off, if you want to turn off. Germany here, they've done it that strange way. Seen any major differences yet? So now I'm concentrating on the driving, so I haven't really been looking too closely. And we may be coming off here actually. What the next country will be. Some cows there, he's taking cows in. I've heard a rumour going to go east. As there's lots of countries east that they haven't covered, going towards Russia. And obviously, we've got Poland, Czechoslovakia, Hungary. We've got those countries. But of course, there's a lot more, isn't there? So. Just what somebody mentioned it on YouTube, so that's true then. That'll be good, that. I mean, we've got Slovakia as well, haven't we? We've already got that. We haven't got Bulgaria. We haven't got Ukraine. Obviously, we've not got Russia. So yeah, that'd be good, that. I also wish they'd do Spain. Are we coming off here? No. I'm sure they'll do Spain eventually, I hope so. Like these trucks have got the same idea as me. This, you know, it's staying out of this right hand lane. It's like I say, if you're constantly switching lanes, you're not coming off. That sat nav's not very clear whether you're coming off or not, but I can see now that we're not coming. Speed camera up. Stick to the rules, eh? Yeah, we've got just over half a tank over. She's a 12 speed, so we have 12 gears. I can't remember what the engine is, but it's quite powerful. 12 speed gearbox. Top of the range, costs a lot of money. Can't remember exactly what it was. I like it because she's very, very spacious. There's a bed at the back. So you can pull over and have a sleep. And she'll pull anything. Cargo and everything, she'll pull it elsewhere. Right, are we coming into southern Germany now? Toll booths in Switzerland, I'm sure they do. There's a speed camera. You spot them easy, can't you? Okay, they're quite hidden. As I've noticed in Europe, you can't miss them really. People think that there's no speed limits on the autobahns in Germany, but that's a myth. There are lots of speed limits on the autobahns. You may get sections where there aren't, but most of the time there are speed limits. Same in Italy as well. Zurich, I'm sure we're going to Zurich, aren't we? So this guy passed it. Here comes the rain. Always has to rain, doesn't it? This is what we need now to put the fires out. For anyone who's interested, this is Saddled With War, is where the fires are, and there was another one today, a new one, which broke out on Winter Hill, which is just outside of Bolton. that's a new fire that's started today. Lightning there. It'll be slowed right down here. What's this? Been an accident? Is it merging? Not very good at merging the AI. Oh, you'll notice for the first time that I've done it on. Put the webcam on. I thought I'd try it out. I mean, it's not brilliant quality, the webcam. It's not a top of the range one. Be interesting to see how it comes out. I've shoved it up in the top left corner. I would think we're coming into southern Germany. This guy's struggling here, isn't he? Can't see anything in front of him. I just don't think he's got the power there to go up. Might be a good idea now. Get some fuel. Fill her up. That'll be enough then to do the job. What is the price there? €1.40. Yeah. Good. see where we are, eh? Where are we here? Ah, we're coming in. Yeah, coming into Switzerland now. And then... Zurich. And then into Northern Italy. Okay. Should have a vape. Yeah, here's the border. So we're in Switzerland now. Told boobs, it might be wrong, Switzerland might not. I know France definitely does, and Poland. 100% sure about Switzerland, I think they do. This is one of them very tight turnings. Cycle lane this. I mean, why would you have a lane this narrow? I ask you. That AI car that came on, I mean, people just wouldn't. See, it was turning, you just wouldn't do that. That car would have stopped and waited for me to turn. Now, there's a guy broke down there. I've not seen that before. Not in Euro Truck. So, he's on the hard shoulder and he's had hazard lights on and obviously he's broke down. So that's definitely new. I'd not seen it before anyway. How much damage did he do? Well, there's no damage to the trailer, that's all I'm bothered about. So. I think that 3%, I think there was some tyre wear anyway before we actually set off, so obviously you can get your truck repaired, not a problem, you just get it serviced and it'll fix anything, and you always get tyre wear. This is one of them drop off lanes again. Yeah, you put them in, put your truck in for a service and they'll service it and fix anything, but you can't fix trailers, you damage trailers. can't be, obviously they're not your trailers, and when you get to your destination, your delivery point, they inspect the trailer, and if there's any damage, you get charged for it, take it off your fee. So that's the important thing, don't damage your trailer. I think that car went into the side of the truck because we hadn't actually turned the trailer at that point, so we're okay having a lane this narrow without a sharp turn, yeah, it's not so bad, but on a sharp turn you know, you gotta think about trucks, you need more room than that. Let's get our lights on. See, really, I should be in that right-hand lane, the slow lane. You'd be constantly having to change lanes there. Get in Italy because we have separate lanes for turning off, so you can actually stay in the slow lane. You'll see what I mean when we get in Italy, I'll explain it to you. So I would imagine we'll be going through quite a few bridges here, tunnels. As they just went through the mountains rather than go around the mountains, they just went through them. I've actually been to Switzerland, so this is exactly how it is. There is one very long tunnel, I can't remember the name of it, in Switzerland. It seems to go on for miles and miles. Sometimes these tunnels are closed. You have to use the tunnel for the opposite side of the road, so there would just one tunnel with traffic going in either direction. As you can see, the only traffic using this tunnel is the traffic going south. So it's a two-lane. Quite a long time. drove through, I'm not sure. I think it is. It seems to go on forever. I've actually been on this route and it in real life, and it takes you to south of Switzerland and the north of Italy. You're coming to Milan then. No, there are no toll booths, are there? Not in Switzerland. They are in Italy. Definitely in Italy. So once we get into Italy, we'll use the automatic because we've got a prepaid card. So we don't have to stop and fiddle about money. So automatically charges as we go through. So we should come to the border soon of Switzerland and Italy. The old borders, because they don't have borders now, do they? Traffic's quite heavy for night time. If you look at all the buttons you've got here, the dash, there's another breakdown there, you see it? All those buttons, look at them all. Like the cockpit of an aeroplane, isn't it? This. probably be close to the border now. Switzerland's not a big country. Had a look there at the temperature. Here's the border. So we're now in Italy. And expect toll booths now. So this is northern Italy, and then it's just a straight drive down the central Italy, I suppose you could call it. You see that sign there, that's the toll booth, right? It's letting you know the toll booth's coming. We want the automatic. No messing about, just automatically charges us. Make sure nothing's coming up the side there. Come racing up the side there sometimes. Now you see here, there's a turn off coming. But to turn off, you have to move over to the right, which is exactly like the UK. So there's no having to switch lanes all the time, unless you're actually coming off. Makes a big difference that. Very good at merging the AI. They tend to just stop instead of just merging on. Okay. I thought it was just going to stop there then. Rail network there. So that's one where it does drop off, but the majority don't. imagine it'll get light soon. Oh, look at that. Yeah, I've not seen that before either, so I take it that's one of the new things. Some emergency vehicles there. That looked like an accident, didn't it? Been an accident. There's a fire engine in a police car. I think it was an ambulance as well. Toll booth now. We want the auto. A few hours yet before it starts getting light. I don't mind night driving, me. But obviously, when you're filming, people like to see the scenery. Puts a lot of it off at night time. Size fuel tank this is. I'll have to have a look at these things. Seems to be quite a big one because I think I could have done this trip without even stopping for fuel. And some of the trucks, fuel tanks are not that large. But this is a top end one. It's probably got a large fuel tank on it. I'll have to look at the specs of it. The power of the engine. What gearbox is fitted. Size of the fuel tank. So glad they've done the whole of Italy. At first it was just the north. So we always had the north of Italy, but now it's the whole of Italy. Well, suddenly everything came to a stop then. This guy here with the locks. Yeah, you can go right down to the bottom of Italy. Sicily and all that, and it's quite a long drive obviously, but the scenery is fantastic down there. Now then, I think I'm coming off here. Morning's coming now. It must be about 4 o'clock in the morning. Police have pulled somebody over there. nice of them. The fans, though, the fans, aren't they? Yeah, the fans. Strange how the road splits there, isn't it? Off separately, doesn't it? Trucks out back of there. See vans much in your old shop, so I wonder if that's a new thing. We've always had the cars and other trucks, buses. I don't recall seeing many vans. Let's right, so where we are. This is where we're going. Pescara. Now you'd say it. Come all the way from there, that's where we started off. So we're not so far now. Yeah, I could have easily done it without stopping for fuel. Thank you. people that shuts lanes down. Shuts your lane down. Sun's well up now, isn't it? So it should all be daylight now, all the way to the delivery point. Switch to daylights now. Braking going on here. Imagine there'll be another toll booth soon. So we would be buying all this honey, that's what he told us. Are we taking it to a distributor? Somebody that supplies. Honey to the local shops. There's the ocean. the Italian police. So it's not far from Rome. Rome is like central Italy. I think we're delivering this to a farm or something, you know. Just got a feeling. Might be wrong, but this work. €20. Suppose we have covered half of Italy, haven't we? So roundabouts are just not built. Damage done though. So another round. This has a larger turn off point, so yeah, it easier. You gotta get lost here, you know. I've got a sat nav here, but it looks as if it's just straight ahead here. I can actually see the delivery point coming up here. See on the sat nav there where you got that flashing circle with a flag? That is at the actual delivery point. I haven't been here before, so that's good. So that'll be another place discovered. Here on the right here. This is how I deliver it. Okay, where do you want it? Where do you need it? Okay. That's the hardest one. I'm okay. I'm okay there, so definitely alright that side, right. Down here, isn't it? It's alright. So I'm going to have to come in at this angle here. Swinging round. This here, haven't you? Doesn't help. So she's more or less looking at that mirror there, she's more or less in the right area. Thank you. wonder if going I could get her to see, I think it'd be easier now to swing it in from this angle. Got to change the approach. Okay. It's all these things that are in the way here. Purposely like dumb like that. Let's get the parking. Wanna do the parking. Trailer there is preventing she's going in. There we go. Now we're talking. It's basically squared on there, isn't it? There she is. Yeah. Let's drop it. accident. Only delivered. So it was a distribution place, wasn't it? Excellent, except for the parking. But they put those things in the way, don't they? And it just makes it that little bit more tricky then. Obviously, without those obstacles there, you wouldn't have to be quite precise with your approach to it. Right. So that's the job done. Got all the money, 73,000. Good. Right then, we'll leave it there. Until the next one. Hope you enjoyed it. And details of this is it. 750 brake horsepower. I was just wondering what the power was of the engine. Yeah. Right then, until the next time everyone, take care, thanks for watching and hopefully you join me again, okay, see you all lads, thanks.